said, I think thoughts of peace and not of affliction. You will call upon me, and I will answer you, and I will lead you back, your captives, from every place. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
This morning we'll be taking the Mass formulary for a time of civil disturbance. And as we gather, let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
You were sent to heal the contrite heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to heal sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, merciful and strong, who crush wars and cast down the proud, be pleased to banish violence swiftly from our country, and to wipe away all tears, so that we may all truly deserve to be called your children. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the beginning of the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, in times past, God spoke in partial and various ways to our ancestors through the prophets. In these last days, he spoke to us through the Son, whom he made heir of all things, and through whom he created the universe, who is the refulgence of his glory, the very imprint of his being, and who sustains all things by his mighty word. When he had accomplished purification from sins, he took his seat at the right hand of the Majesty on high, as far superior to the angels, as the name he has inherited is more excellent than theirs. For to which of the angels did God ever say, "You are my son, this day I have begotten you"? Or again, "I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me"? And again, when he leads the firstborn into the world, he says, "Let all the angels of God worship him." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let all his angels worship him.
Let all his angels worship him.
The Lord is king. Let the earth rejoice. Let the many isles be glad. Justice and judgment are the foundation of his throne.
Let all his angels worship him.
The heavens proclaim his justice, and all peoples see his glory. Let all his angels worship him.
Let all his angels worship him.
Because you, O Lord, are the Most High over all the earth, exalted far above all gods.
Let all his angels worship him. glory to you, Lord.
After John had been arrested, Jesus came to Galilee proclaiming the gospel of God. This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. As he passed by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting their nets into the sea. They were fishermen. Jesus said to them, "Come after me, and I will make you fishers of men." Then they left their nets and followed him. He walked along a little farther and saw James, the son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They too were in a boat, mending their nets. Then he called them. So they left their father Zebedee in the boat, along with the hired men, and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Christmas season is over, ended yesterday night, last night. Today we'll begin the process of undecorating the church. And we begin a period of 5 weeks of ordinary time, which doesn't mean humdrum time, it means order in the sense of number. You enter the first week. As we begin this celebration, we are going to listen for the next 5 weeks. Our first readings every day will be from the letter to the Hebrews, and the Gospels will be from the Gospel of Mark. And today, Monday, the first week, a very important day in those readings. First reading, the book of Hebrews, is the beginning of the letter. And it is very much like the prologue in the Gospel of St. John that we read at Christmas Day Mass just a few weeks ago. It's like a big bang. It gives the whole mystery of Christ almost in your face. So listen to it just a little bit again when Paul writes, brothers and sisters, times past, generations before us, God spoke in partial, in various ways, to all of our ancestors through the prophets. But now, in these last days, he spoke to us through his Son. His Son, then he goes on to describe whom he made heir of all things, through whom he created the universe. The Son is the refulgence of his glory, the very imprint of his being, and he sustains all things through his word. It would take more than a lifetime to ponder that great mystery. St. Mark takes a much different approach. It is as if St. Paul, in the letter to the Hebrews, let the cat out of the bag and told us, who is this Jesus Christ? St. Mark is going to lead us to that same conclusion, but step by step by step, brick by brick. And he begins, as he begins today, with the beginning of Jesus' public ministry. After his baptism by John in Judea, and after John is arrested, perhaps because he fears arrest himself, Jesus goes back to Galilee, where he This is the refulgence of God's glory, the very imprint of his being, who sustains the entire universe by his word, goes for a little walk along the sea of Galilee. That contrast is something we need to keep in mind for the next 5 weeks, until we begin the season of Lent. As St. Mark tells us this marvelous mystery, that this Son of God, through whom everything was made, who sustains everything in being, who is the very imprint of the Father, can go for a walk along the Sea of Galilee, and along the way say, "Come, follow me." Every one of us has been summoned by this refulgence of the Father, this sustainer of the universe and creator of the universe, to follow him. In one of our Eucharistic prayers, not the one we use today, but we refer to everyone who is present at Mass as God's family, whom he has summoned before him. You are called to be here today by the grace of God. Jesus called you just as he called Simon and Andrew, James and John, when he went out for a little walk along the beach. We are dealing here with the whole mystery of the Incarnation, of God becoming one of us, human, so that he could go out for a walk, and yet the sustainer and creator of all things. So as we listen in the Gospel of Mark each day to a new episode unfolding how this God came to us and is with us today, I want to keep these two things in mind: the great grandeur of the mystery revealed in the beginning of the letter to the Hebrews, and then its actualization step by step, little by little, action by action, episode by episode, in the Gospel of Mark. We learn from this mystery and grow to love the Word who made us and then who came to live with us. Let us lay our petitions before our Heavenly Father.
For those in the church entrusted with the spiritual care of others, may God grant them wisdom and compassion. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, may God continue to convert their hearts to the beauty of peace and justice for all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are suffering in mind, body, or spirit, may the loving hand of Jesus provide consolation even amidst continued hardship. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community of faith, may God's grace help us as we respond to Jesus' call to participate in building the kingdom of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died in the light of faith, may the mercy of our loving Father usher them into the fullness of eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the healing of our nation from the pandemic and from civil unrest, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Merciful Father, hear the prayers of your people, respond to them with the love and power of your Spirit, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. And glory of his name for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be mindful, Lord, that your Son, who himself is peace, has destroyed our hatreds by his blood. Look in mercy on our evil deeds and grant that to those whom you love, this sacrifice may restore peace and tranquility through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners. And he became a neighbor to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father, and that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so, with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name, and sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race, to always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the grave. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted and until the day of eternity, among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Timothy, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly, after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all your saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the
sins
of
the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace.
Thank you.
Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you, says the Lord. Not as the world is, do I give it to you. Do not let your hearts be troubled or afraid. Let us pray. Grant to us, O Lord, that nourished with the delights of the one bread that fortifies the human heart, we may successfully overcome the fury of disturbance and resolutely keep your law of love and justice through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you. Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We'll now have